Hello everyone, this is lecture 1, class 9th, subject English. In this lecture, we are going to discuss chapter 3 of Moments, that is Ishwaran the Storyteller, written by R.K. Lakshman, and this story is from your book Moments. Now, let's have a look on the introduction of the chapter. This story revolves around a junior construction supervisor, Mahendra, and his domestic help, Ishwaran. He is fond of telling exaggerated stories to his master. He was so talented in this art of storytelling that the listener would feel it as real. So this story is about one man, Mahendra, whose job is to work as a junior construction supervisor and who was always accompanied by his domestic helper, that is Ishwaran. Ishwaran was fond of telling stories to his master as he was blessed with this talent of storytelling that the listener would feel it as real. One evening, Ishwaran tells Mahendra a ghost story which Mahendra does not believe. But on waking up at night, he thinks that he saw a ghost and he gets disturbed and thus decides to leave the place the next day. So once what happened while narrating stories, that was the daily routine of Ishwaran. He narrated one ghost story, but his master Mahendra did not believe. But after few days he saw the ghost, and having confirmed the same from Ishwaran, he decided to leave the haunted place forever. So let's see what happened actually, what was the story and how did the story impact Mahendra. Let's have a look on the summary of the chapter. So Mahendra was a supervisor in a firm. His job was to supervise different construction sites. Nature of his job was to move from one place to another place. Mahendra's needs were simple. He had a servant named Ishwaran. So Mahendra was a supervisor. His job was to supervise the work at a construction site, and once the job would be over, he used to be shifted to another construction site. Thus, the nature of his job was to move from one place to another. His needs were simple as he was a bachelor. He had kept a servant named Ishwaran for domestic work. Ishwaran followed Mahendra without any complaint. He cooked for Mahendra, washed his clothes and cleaned the shelter. In leisure time, that means in his free time, Ishwaran read Tamil thrilled stories. Ishwaran described each thing in detail and he weaved daily a new story full of thrill and horror to Mahendra. That means the daily routine of Ishwaran was to cook for Mahendra, wash his clothes and cleanse the shelter. In his free time, he used to read Tamil thrill stories and used to narrate the same in detail to his master Mahendra. He played the role of a TV in Mahendra's quarter. Once he told to Mahendra a story about Tusker with the prolonged of elephant in the jungle and how they behaved when they got mad. The tusker escaped out of the jungle, destroying everything what came into the way. So Ishwaran, despite doing the household work, he was serving as a full source of entertainment and also was a replacement of a TV in Mahendra's quarter. He used to read Tamil stories and this affected him so much that even a small incident like a fallen tree appeared to him a bushy beast. He used to read everything in detail and weaved a story full of thrill and horror to Mahendra every day. Once Ishwaran told Mahendra a story about his school days, describing a tusker and how he behaved when he got mad. The tusker escaped out of a timber yard, destroying everything that came in this way. It reached in Ishwaran's school. There, everyone was terrified, watching the drama of the tusker. It pulled football goalpost and volleyball net. Later, Ishwaran told that he grabbed a cane from the teacher's hand and faced the mad tusker boldly. So he was describing the incident that when the tusker entered Ishwaran's school, he was not terrified, whereas everyone else was so scared that they were looking towards the tusker in a strange way. But Ishwaran grabbed a cane from a teacher's hand and faced the mad tusker boldly. He hit sharply with the cane onto the third toe of 1 foot of the elephant. Right? So he hit onto the third toe of the foot of the elephant and it shivered and collapsed. At this point, Ishwaran would leave the story and Mahendra remained in a dangling situation. That means he used to keep thinking as what would have happened after that. This was the art of storytelling of Ishwaran. Now, what happened after few days? It was a full moon night, and on that auspicious day, he weaved a story about a ghost woman holding a fetus in her hand. So, on a full moon night, Ishwaran had prepared delicious food and he weaved a story about a ghost woman holding a fetus in her hands on a full moon night. Mahendra asked him to stop telling him such nonsense stories, as Mahendra did not believe in ghosts, and he told Ishwaran that there are no such type of figures, but this is only a part of our imagination only. One night, now what happened after that? One night, as Mahendra was asleep, he was awakened by the sound of someone crying. He heard something, that someone is crying, some strange noise was there. He thought that it could be a cat looking for mice and tried to go back to sleep. Initially, he thought that the sound was of a cat and he tried to sleep again, but the sound became more harsh and seemed to be a human sound. Mahendra wanted to peep, that means he wanted to look out of the window, but stopped himself as he was afraid that if he saw a ghost, he could even die. Mahendra could not stop himself, and so he bent down and lifted his head slightly in order to peep out, in order to look out, as he could not sleep back and the sound was becoming more louder and louder. In the white colored moonlight, Mahendra saw the ghost. It was holding a bundle in one hand. Mahendra panicked. He was breathing heavily and fell back on the bed. That day, that night, he saw a ghost that left him panicked and he fell back on the bed. Now, what happened? It was confirmed the next day. Mahendra was getting ready for his office when it was confirmed by Ishwaran that Mahendra had seen the ghost the previous night and it was not a trick played by his mind. Initially, Mahendra thought that it was a type of trick played by his subconscious mind. But the very next morning, it was confirmed by Ishwaran that it was not a trick. Once again, Mahendra was frightened. He left in a hurry and resigned from the job. He could not live at a haunted place for a single day. So he decided to resign the same day, as he could not live at a haunted place for a single day. So this was about this chapter, Ishwaran, the storyteller, whose story had impacted his master so much that he had started believing in ghosts, and even his subconscious mind had played a trick or might be it was a real ghost which was seen by him. See, new words. First, ill-equipped means not having proper facilities. Next, makeshift means temporary. Next, conjure up means make. Next, hold in thrall means captivate attention. Next, sprawled, that means lie or to spread out. Next, mahout, a person who controls an elephant. Next, prologue means introduction. Next, emulation means imitation, copying. Next, depredations means destruction or damage. Next, trumpeted means cried loudly, used for elephant. Next, credible, that can be believed. Next, culinary skills means cooking skills. Reverie, daydreaming. Figment means made up. Next, prowling. Prowling means move in a quiet manner. Next, feline, like a cat. Panting means breathing with short, quick breaths, as Mahendra was doing when he saw the ghost that night. That was panting. Ghastly, causing horror or fear. Subconscious, part of mind which we are unaware of. Now we will look for key points. First, Mahendra was a bachelor, a junior supervisor in a construction firm. He always had his asset. Who was his asset? His cook, Ishwaran, with him. And he had amazing capacity to produce vegetable and cooking ingredients anywhere. That means wherever they were supposed to shift. Due to the work type of Mahendra, when they were supposed to shift to other places, Ishwaran had the amazing capacity to arrange suitable eating ingredients for his master. He weaved endless stories and played a role of TV in Mahendra's living quarters. He weaved a tale of a tusker which destroyed everything on the way and how he made him collapse in the end with help of a small cane and karate. So he weaved a story of a tusker with which he fought so bravely as he had learned the art of judo karate. Ishwaran linked the auspicious full moon night to a story of female ghost holding a fetus. So one day he told him a ghost story that was the auspicious day of full moon night. Mahendra rebuked him, stopped him and scolded him for explaining such baseless stories. He thought that was only a figment of imagination and nothing else. But one night Mahendra heard a low moan, a low sound near his window. He put it as a cat. Initially, he thought it as a cat, but sound became louder and louder and appeared to him strange and somehow appeared to him as if the sound was of a human voice. Mahendra saw a cloudy figure holding a bundle. It affected him very much that he could not sleep properly. So that day, that his imagination or that cloudy figure who was holding a bundle which he saw affected him so much that he could not sleep that night. And next morning, Ishwaran greeted him and told him about the last night's experience. That means the presence of that ghost was confirmed by Ishwaran. And having it confirmed, he decided to leave the place the very next day. So he resigned from the job and he decided to leave that haunted place forever. So this was about this chapter number 3, Ishwaran the storyteller. Homework is, read the chapter carefully and do the textual questions in your English Fair notebook. First, go through the chapters, go for the new words, look for their meanings, then key points, and then the explanation of the chapter, and then only go for solving the questions. That is, you have to do all the textual questions which are given after the chapter in your moments book, and you are supposed to do all the textual questions in your English Fair notebook only.